What is a slip disc? So everyone's heard of the term slip disc. This might be someone you know, it might be someone you work with, it might be you. Having had some sort of back problem, usually one that's pretty severe, and they said, well, you are suffering from a slip disc. So today we're going to talk about what that actually is and what it means and what's really happening. So for those of you who don't know, I'm going to pull out a spine here. This is somewhat like what your spine looks like in your body. So it's a stack of bones all the way down to the pelvis. And in between those bones, here in the yellow bits, those are your discs. So the bones are hard, like a bone would be. The discs are made of connective tissue. So they're soft, stretchy, fibrous connective tissue. And in the discs of the spine, there's a little bit of a fluid in the middle to help control how it works. Now, when we think of a slip disc, I've actually seen this, how it's made in diagrams. Sometimes they show this disc as being a separate piece that can shift from where it belongs. Imagine like this one here, it's loose. Imagine that if it could move. And when we think of a slip disc, we think that disc has moved from where it belongs. In a real human body, all these bones and these discs are completely encased in connective tissue. These discs are actually made of connective tissue, and the fibers from this connective tissue goes into the bone, so it can't slip. If you were to take this out of a human body and try to separate this, you would not be able to separate it. You're not strong enough, and most it would take a machine to try to separate those. So there's no way that that disc can actually slip. To make a more accurate analogy, I've made something here. What I've made here, this is using two coffee cups and some tape. We're going to imagine that this is more likely how a disc works and how it looks. We're going to picture that this is a bone in your spine and this is a bone in your spine. Hard, bony substances. They even have these little parts in the back so we could visualize it better. The disc in your spine is not a separate piece that can slide out, but it's more like tape. Here I used some athletic tape, but I want you to imagine it like packing tape that's wrapped around many, many, many thick layers, and in the middle is a little bit of a gelatinous space, or it acts like a bearing. So in this part, I can't separate this, and this disc can't slip. Okay, what this disc does is it controls how this bone can move on top of this bone, so it keeps them together, but allows them to, not much, but I can flex this a little bit this way and that way, and the shape of the bones here, they're square coffee cups, but in your body they're shaped like kidney bones. Those shapes, and along with the accessory joints, control how it's able to move. So it can move a little bit, but not too much, and that's what gives us the fact that it can move a little bit means that we have flexibility, but the fact that it's controlled motion, that it doesn't move too much, means that we're protected from damaging the connective tissue. We're protected from damaging how the muscles work. So there's control, but there's flexibility. It's a trade-off. Now, like I said, in the real world, this cannot slip. It's not a separate thing. They're well entrenched. Those two pieces are made together. They fit together. They work together. But in the real world, things can happen that can affect this relationship between this bone and this bone. There can be forces that come from outside. So I want you to think of things like car accidents, falls, sports injuries. And if those come and they're strong enough, they're going to start to disrupt this tape. They're going to separate it out. They're going to start to split the fibers in the tape. Okay. And besides those big forces like that, there are going to be other smaller forces that happen over and over and over. So if we sit poorly, if we wear bad shoes, if I push on this over and over and over and over, eventually what's going to happen is we're going to start to loosen up certain fibers, other fibers will be stretched. Okay, and that's more accurate a description of what happens when we say we have a slipped disc. What's happened is we've changed the properties of that disc that was meant to hold these two in proper, perfect alignment. Now we've stretched some of the fibers, some of them have ripped. Other fibers will start to bunch up. Just think about like how saran wrap does. If you allow it to, it'll start to coalesce. And that's the same thing that happens to these fibers in this disc. Okay, so here we have a disc. It's healthy. I'm going to start to put some forces on it. You can start to hear it. We're damaging some of those fibers. And now, this doesn't move like it should. Okay, so what we've done is we've taken a disc that was controlling the motion of these vertebrae. We've had an outside force come in that a little bit more than the body could handle. We've changed the disc. Sometimes you use the word disc, not necessarily, but we do have damage in the connective fibers of the disc that's allowed certain motions to happen that maybe shouldn't happen. Remember, the motion was controlled before, and now it's not controlled. And this is what we're aiming to undo when we're doing conservative care, which is, in my case, corrective chiropractic care or structural correction or posture correction, however you guys watching. I want you to go ahead and if you like this video, please click like. If you liked it a lot, go ahead and share it. And if you like this video a whole bunch, why don't you subscribe so you can watch more. Talk to you guys later.